We here, man. It's Music in a Bottle podcast.
Big,
man.
Big music.
Big music bottle. In the bottle podcast.
Big pod.
In the building, man. I'm sorry. I'm trying to connect. Music in a Bottle podcast, episode 139.
39.
Popping champagne like we. That took me back.
Feel like I got on a championship ring.
Oh, yeah, we ball harder.
I am the bird man.
Ara. Start with straight shots and then pop bottles. Pour it on the models. Shut up, bitch. Swallow.
If you can't swallow.
Shut up, bitch. Straight up out that water with my boss.
I don't buy much. I buy land, bro.
Hey.
Cologne, Germany.
We here, man.
McDonald's every time I land.
Music in a Bottle podcast, episode 139, man.
139, baby. We here.
Where y'all at?
Turn up with them boys.
Where y'all at?
We the best dressed in this motherfucker. Let's go.
Come on, man.
Feels good today, bro.
Big protein.
Yeah, this
big
is protein.
Big protein.
Y'all gotta stop playing, bro. I swear.
Gotta stop playing.
Yeah.
Fuck up the world, excuse me, but is that your
come on, man.
Good boy.
Where we at?
If she tell us a good girl.
I'm not good with the regular girls.
Yeah.
I never want a veteran girl. I just might change your life. We ain't wearing no just happy jeans. We ain't doing none of normal things.
Hey.
You know what?
Come on, man.
Standard, you know. I lost the plot. Principles, yeah, I'd rather not. Messy, about to come in hot.
Hey.
Dot. We gon' fuck up the world. Excuse me, but is that your girl?
Huh?
Didn't mean to possess your girl. Baby, I'm high pro.
Come on, man.
He's
thinking
this. Didn't mean to possess your girl.
Hey. I'm a passionate Neymar. He got time for your bestie, girl. Niggas know that I'm best dressed. Hey. Do I profile to access? I ain't even got a fact check. All I'm wearing is Wells Bonner. Feeling good, I might wear no. Matter of fact,
come
let's
on.
Be platonic.
I just fuck. Ain't that ironic?
Hey.
You picked a bunker bed. Either way, I'ma want some head.
Hey.
We grew up around trifling hoes. You ain't get nothing out.
Oh my god.
Hey,
too hot, bro. I'm Baby Keem. I wouldn't call it close.
Hey.
Messy, get them girls off the stage. Cause somebody's gonna get taken. Somebody's gonna invade on a one-on-one conversation. I'm ducked off from the world.
The Range
I'm
Brothers are back, baby.
And I ain't worried about her.
Can we keep it a big buck and this is sticky though? We go keep it a buck and say this is sticky though?
I don't know, man.
This is sticky, bro. This is sticky 2.0.
I don't know, man.
You run sticky for me one time.
This is definitely sticky. It's hard though. But it's sticky. It's hard.
I don't know, man.
What don't you know?
I don't know, man.
I think this is when we start getting. This is when niggas start trying to front. On the boy.
Their flow is so lazy compared to this. This was so active and so assertive. And so in your face.
It was still the same cadence.
Yeah.
Same cadence.
Hey.
Hanging on my neck.
Come on. We doing the same thing.
Stop all that back and forth
over the net. Yeah.
My mama wish I would've went corporate. She wish I would've went exec.
She did.
I still turned to a CEO. So the lifestyle she respect.
Come on.
Hey.
Two sprinters to Quebec.
Hey.
What? Come on, man.
You know I gotta bring
the G block. You know I gotta bring the D block. Cause you know how sticky it gets.
Man.
Yeah.
You know how sticky it gets.
Yeah.
You know how sticky it gets. You know how sticky it gets.
Not here.
Not right here. But the actual
second verse. Top of the second verse, yes. Right here.
Hey yo, Eric, bring them girls to the stage. Cause somebody's getting paid. Free big slime out the cage.
This is it, bro.
I
don't mind it. I like it actually a lot. If everybody raps like this for a year, I'm cool.
I don't buy much. I buy land, bro.
I gotta go back. I gotta go back because I don't hear. Y'all hear?
Yes, I hear, bro. Just go to
principles. Yeah, I'd rather not. Messy about to come in hot.
Dot. We gon' fuck up the world. Excuse me.
Come on, man. Come on. I don't know, man.
It's there.
I can see it.
Is it there? All right, let's go ahead and start this part off, man. This is Music in a Bottle podcast, episode 139. We are in the month of June. Big shout out to Jay Fave, man.
The birthday boy.
Play this one because he just celebrated his anniversary, man. Birthday 31.
Big 31.
Yes. Where else we at, bro?
Big 2 years.
2 years. That's crazy.
That is crazy.
Big 2 years.
Appreciate y'all for being a part of the day too.
Yes, sir.
Of course, man. I remember like it was yesterday.
I remember it too. Shit, it was a lot warmer that day than it was today. What the
hell
fuck?
Yeah, and it was hot
as hell. We ain't got a day like that yet this year.
And Katie has some of them ones in there.
She did.
Respectfully.
Yeah.
Respectfully.
We love women.
Squad.
Yeah.
Definitely. Y'all had charcuterie too, huh?
Charcuterie and charcuterie. The big charcuterie.
Yeah, definitely.
That bitch was big as hell. Niggas ain't finished that. The flies got to it before we could finish that motherfucker.
I just remember the sangrias. I had about 12. I was sweating the bitches right out. Them motherfuckers, they was coming in. And hey. Yeah, killed it. Big shout out to Kenzie.
Yeah, facts.
I didn't even drink that much, to be honest.
Big shout out.
I couldn't because that drive was too long, yo. Y'all wanted to get married in the middle of Fucksville.
In the middle of what?
In the middle of Fucksville. I couldn't get lit if I wanted to in that bitch, bro. I'm like, shit, let me
hey there. Pull over before you head out.
Hey, where are you headed?
It was a straight drive down Alpine, bro.
Straight drive these nuts.
Nah, Alpine is it's with the fuckery before you hit.
Hey.
Hey, yo, Alpine. Nah, I'm good. I'm straight.
I was like, bro, I can't even get lit out here, bro.
That shit feel like Jeepers Creepers on the way.
Oh, God.
Once you pass all the shit, it's a wrap,
bro.
Yeah.
It's no lights. Mm-hmm. That's cornfields.
Yeah.
It wasn't nothing out there, bro. I was scared as hell going home. Until I seen the
Who are you with? You with Jamel? I just pulled his ass over too. Wants to say it's his fucking wedding.
You must be with the party. Mm-hmm. We don't party around these parts, boy.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Oh man, we here. Episode 139, man. What's happening, Ranger?
139, man.
Yeah.
Shit, life is good, man.
Life is good.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my boy, Big Blessed. But everything's been good, man. Came back from Chicago. You know, I was out there with Ye, you know.
And they say Shy City.
Big Obla. But it was cool, bro. Shout out to Neocon. It's like this big furniture conference.
It's really dope. I was wondering what it was.
Yeah, bro.
I didn't really get a idea when it was Neo.
Yeah.
And I could have Googled it, but I was just trying to figure out just based off the name.
Essentially, bro, it's the biggest fucking furniture conference in the States. You got different brands from around the world that come into Chicago to this building called the Mart, which is downtown off the water. And so, yeah, it's already a permanent showroom for furniture, but they do a big conference too. Got so it's it. A lot of exhibits that pop up, things like that. I never been that excited to be around furniture in my life. I ain't gonna lie, but it was fire. It was dope.
You had to see some pretty cool shit though.
Yeah. A lot of cool stuff. A lot of advancements in the industry. A lot of attention to detail that, you know, the regular person that's seeing furniture don't really think about in comparison to when you get there. And so, yeah, that was cool. Meeting a lot of people. Like I said, I had a good time. It was dope. It's crazy how these conferences work, though, because this is my first conference. I'm in this bitch, and I'm thinking, you know, I'm strictly business. I walk in there yo, I'm trying to get these contacts, trying to get it going. It's all good. So, first half of the day, go crazy Monday. We go take a lunch break. We come back around 3.
Mm.
Get back to the conference at 3. Everybody's drunk.
Mm-hmm.
The whole thing. Every exhibit got a bar. Every exhibit got a bar. It's candy canes, all types of.
Do you want a jello shot?
Bro, yes.
Check out
this chair with a drink in your hand.
We're doing
I'm like,
acid.
Yo, this don't seem like the safest environment to have all these drinks and drunk people and furniture. No, they don't care, bro. It's a party out there. We get done with everything stops at 5. We go outside and the Mart again is right off the water. So it's like in front of it is almost like a deck. It's like a concrete deck.
Yeah.
Was it at Merchandise Mart or where was it at?
Merchandise Mart.
That's where it was at.
I think that's 2022 Merchandise Street, I think.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. But it's the Mart, big-ass building down there.
Damn.
Yeah. So it was in there. And so it's right outside of it on the Riverwalk is deck. And so you walk out there's an after party happening. Bro, it's lobster rolls on the app. They're walking around with I had 10 lobster rolls, but I'm smashing them joints, going crazy. It was a good time, bro. So shout out to Neocon, shout out to Mart. Definitely a vibe. Had some good connects, met some dope people, so that was cool. Week before that, went camping. First camp of the year, that was fun. Went to Sleeping Bear. That shit was cool too, man. Got to kick it. Love camping as always. It was a little nippy out there this time of year. You know what I'm saying? Still a little chilly out.
A little nip.
But that's been it, man. Big camp doing its thing. Sponsorship dollars rolling in. Mm-hmm. So
let's go.
Can't be mad when the dough come through. Mm-hmm. But shit, bro. Other than that, we fucking blessed, bro. That's the vibe.
Love to hear it.
Did you get mine?
Oh, I'm not playing with you, bro. I'm not playing with you.
I did mine in person.
I ain't playing with you. I did pick up a deer, though.
saw that.
I did pick up a deer.
Hey, yo, this nigga got this. In the past 4 or 5 episodes, this nigga got a hippo.
He didn't mess with an antelope. He's an antelope.
He got the antelope killed.
I got him killed. Oh, that's crazy. Mm-hmm. Like, I worked there.
And now he's got a deer. He picked up a deer.
I did pick up a baby deer, bro. We was on a hike, man. And I think Enzo spotted this nigga. Somebody did. Mm-hmm. But it's a little bro, like newborn deer. Like, I mean, when I'm talking like this big, like newborn deer. And it's sitting on like right off the edge of the trail in the grass. So you could barely see it because the grass tall. And so walk up on it. I'm thinking it's dead. I see it breathing. I'm like, oh, this little nigga alive. Where's mama at? Mama nowhere to be found. You can't see the mama. So everybody like, oh, is he going to die? Does he need water? You know, so we get the water bottles out trying to drink. We put like a little water on his nose. He started licking his nose. We're like, he must be dehydrated. Shit.
100%. Yeah.
So I'm like, shit. I'm the ranger. What I'm going to do? You know, I just had to go. I had to take the name Full of Storms. So I'm like, fuck it. Take my sweatshirt. Take my sweatshirt. You know what I'm saying? Got to put it in the gear.
Cut open that tree right there. Yeah. Pull some aloe vera out.
Out the tree is crazy. Bro, so I take my sweatshirt and I scoop the deer, bro. And I got the deer in my arms maybe for like 3 seconds. And then that nigga spazzed the fuck out and jumped out my arms and like ran into the forest full speed, like limping. I was like, damn, that's kind of crazy. Yeah. But on IG, it looked like I really saved that joint, though. If you see the clip, it looked like I took that nigga home.
Yeah.
But nah, I did. He jumped out my arms like right after that. But content, you know, content. So,
Dr. Wayne Little.
I was going
to
say.
That's crazy. You talked to the animals.
I saw a little.
You see that second where that nigga's. You see a little bit of that nigga's passing, just a tag.
Oh, really? In the video?
Like this much.
Yeah,
like
it's super short.
Like I did edit it to like right there. Yeah, so I did save your deer though because he started walking. So hopefully he's not dead. I think a fox might have got him, to be honest, if we talk in the circle of life. But
that's crazy.
Like, hey.
You did your part.
I did what I could do, bro. I got the nigga out the sand. I got out the grass. But yeah, man. That's been my motherfucking week, bro. It's been adventurous. It's the summer, so this is how it go. The summer is nonstop moving and shaking. So we got some fun, man. We're gonna make some money. Better be busy than broke.
Ain't that the truth? Ain't that the truth, man? What's been up, man? Turned 31 last Thursday.
30 working on me.
Big 31. Celebrated 2 years with the wifey.
Yes, sir.
Did some work events on the east side of the state. Shout out to the wine scene in Detroit. It's a nice little area. Like, it's a nice little vibe. There's like a big connection on like actual like good wine, so it's nice to be around people. Like, Grand Rapids is almost there, but like it's like Chicago, Detroit, like these scenes are kind of like really about it, and like they know like the producers that they want to tap in with. So it's cool to work for a producer that's making real quality wine and to be connected down there. So that was a vibe. Sunday, hung out with some friends. Birthday was cool. Katie and I went out to dinner. Went out to dinner with the in-laws on Saturday. Yeah, it's been big chilling. But I've been telling myself that 31 is about health. So trying to just focus on whether that's mental health, physical health. Just trying to make sure my body is right as we get up there in these years. Making sure that I'm doing the right things that I can do to be a healthier person. So I feel like if I'm healthier, everybody around me thrives a little bit better too. So that's the vibe that we on for this year. And definitely drinking more great wine. So.
I love it. I love it, man.
Facts. Big pod.
Where we at, man?
Homes.
It sounds like I got an echo, though. You hear the echo?
I got an echo.
Who got echo?
Me.
You got an echo?
Do it sound weird?
No.
No?
It do sound like you got an echo a little bit.
Okay.
Oh, I hear it.
I know, we'll figure it out.
Yeah. Sorry, that's cool.
Pod. Sorry, pod.
No, that's okay. Do it again, I kill you. where we at, man? I had a conversation with, like, I'm in a mentor and a mentee group, and then we was talking about depression. And then I kind of went off, and I didn't feel good about it. But I don't know. I thought my thoughts was valid. I was like, yo, depression only exists if you give it power.
I feel that.
So if you say, like, you got depression, like, I was like, damn, like, it only exists if you give it power. If you say depression is made up, then, like, it is what it is. But in the context, it was around work, what we doing right now.
Mm-hmm.
It's work. You know what I mean? And what we do every day is work. And it's like, I think I was more so speaking to the men on their call. It was just the fact that every day you have tasks, and every day you have missions, and every day you have, it's like a video game. Yeah. Like, you gotta get these things done. It does not matter. And unfortunately speaking, for us to sit around, like, and wait in that, or, you know what I mean? Just, like, sit in it. Task and things build up. Like, the men on Titanic, like, the niggas knew. They was scared. But they sat on Titanic and let the women and children, like, live. And then I started thinking about black people in the 50s. And I was like, man, they wasn't getting prescriptions. It's not that it was right. It's not that it was wrong either, though. But, like, right. Them niggas found out how not to be depressed. What the fuck? Like, I don't deserve it. You know what I mean?
Right. 100%.
Insensitive. But also still true. They was doing sit-ins to your face. You know what I mean? Like, for real, for real. Y'all feel me or no? Am I tripping?
No, I get what you're saying. It's just a level of, like, what, like you said, it's what you almost consider. You're giving power to whatever you're considering.
100%.
Especially in these situations where you, like, look, there was a time where niggas really had some shit to be sad about. You know what I'm saying?
Bro, like, I've been in a field all day.
Yeah.
Working. Yeah. Hands cut up.
Wife done had whatever happened.
I don't even know where she at.
Right.
Niggas was too mad to be depressed. Like, they were, like, it was just so much built up anger. It was like,
so where is that? Like, when do men become violent and mad and say, like, all right, I want to change my surroundings? Because we still got that in us.
Right.
That there's nothing wrong with being angry and like a monster and saying, like, fuck it. Like, I have that in me and I'm going to use that and direct my fucking vision and my anger towards something real. Like, whatever my passion is, whatever the fuck I like in my life.
And I think that's what people, or like, that's what we do. Like, I mean, I'm not saying we're angry, but, like, we get up, we go to work because we know we want to achieve this. We know we want to get here. We know we want to get there. Yeah.
Because if you didn't have that, you wouldn't move. Like, if there was no, there has to be fuel to the fire, right? Like, that's the reason niggas obsess over what they do. Or that's the reason, like, you go the hours you go in. Like, niggas work when they're tired. Niggas work when they're dirt tired. And it's like, before, especially when you talk about a time like that, them niggas ain't have a choice to. And so it's like, on our end, I think because we're in a space where, I don't know, I think it's just you got that, because you got so many options, I think a lot of times niggas don't focus.
Yeah.
And when you don't focus, failure is inevitable. And I think for me personally, the fear of failing is what keeps me going.
Mm-hmm.
But for the next nigga, it's like the fear of failing might keep them stagnant. They don't move. And they stay stuck in, like, one space. And they just be sad about it.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? So
they don't even try. It's called analysis paralysis. I see it all the time with investors. Yeah. Like, they before they have the bread. I'm talking 740 credit score. This is
right.
Now they be ready to go. And it's like an analysis paralysis. Like, they don't even get started. They so scared to make a mistake. But it, and just in terms of life, like, I feel like... bad shit is gonna happen to you no matter what. Like, that's gonna happen. People are gonna die. You know what I mean? And it's just like fucking
shit
hard.
Happens all the time.
But I will not stand in depression. Like, I will not be that person. I will not.
Yeah.
Because at the end of one run, 4 miles, or at the end of one exercise, one hoop session, my dopamine is so fucking high that I'm how? Healthy body equals healthy mind. No doubt about it. So
actual.
That's what I've been thinking about a lot this week.
Talk this woke, man.
Talk this shit.
Definitely. In terms of wine, what are we drinking on, gentlemen? Crazy transition. Bananas. I got y'all first. I feel like I got the easiest to pronounce. I got Born Rosé. This is a brewed out of Barcelona.
Barcelona.
But yeah, man. This one, I picked this one out because it was sparkling. We're at 11.5% alcohol. By volume, this is imported in Minneapolis, believe it or not. That's interesting. Sparkling rosé wine. Super excited to get through this one. First couple sips have been great. There is no while it is a rosé, this is not on the sweet side. I'm thoroughly enjoying this one, but I'm about to try what Jamele got in a second. So
I like it.
Yeah,
get it.
I like it.
I got the Veritas Scintilla out of Monticello, Virginia, from Veritas Vineyard and Winery. Again, shout out to the homie Reggie. This one is sitting at motherfucking 12.5% alcohol, but done in the traditional method. So, again, a bubbly that's made like champagne coming out of France. But right now, it's hitting right now. I'm enjoying it right now, so I'll let y'all know how it is by the end of the show, though.
I like it. I like it. I got the Inspiration 1818 Brut non-vintage 12% alcohol content.
The real champagne.
Real champagne. This is property of France. You know what I'm saying?
Big time.
This is champagne, nigga. Not sparkling wine, nigga. Big champagne, nigga.
Big. Big champagne. You know the region.
Yeah, 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 yeah. You know the vibes.
Come on, man. Don't look at me. Yeah. Stupid.
Yeah. So we on that, man. Mm-hmm. First couple sips taste great. I'll let y'all know how I feel at the end of the show.
18, 18, 1, 8, 1, 8, 9 plus 9. What's that?
Mm.
Shit.
18. Bro, crazy as hell, ain't it? Got y'all niggas.
27.
Got y'all niggas.
Shit, motherfucking.
Oh, man. My God. All right.
Let's get
to it.
Let's go.
Hey, what's going on? It's Music in a Bottle podcast.
We back.
Yes, we got a lot to talk about, man. First off, Hillbillies by we covered dive. Hillbillies by the Range Brothers.
I think we're all in agreement it was fire.
Yeah, I think it was fire.
We heard in a while.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was heat.
Definitely, I've been coming back to that Don Toliver like crazy, yo.
Hey, you've been on that thing.
I know,
since
man.
It came out. I ain't gonna cap. Like,
bro, you've been lovesick.
Yeah, yeah, you have been lovesick.
I love you. But I can hate you at the same time.
Ranks.
We got them at the same time. Yeah. Which y'all been listening to, though? For real, for real.
Shit, man.
So who came out this week?
Who been in Roto? In Roto, I've been listening to...
So you like that Honeymoon, too, don't you?
Which one? Who you talking about?
That Don Toliver, because man just rapped the whole verse with me. Yeah.
I mean,
that shit slapped.
I mean, I know it.
Yeah. Oh, I forgot. Who told you?
Oh, this did drop. Hey. I did forget about this. I did.
Don't tell me about that. Oh, my God.
Come on, man.
Yeah.
Come on, man.
Actually, it was mid, but it was a good mid.
It was a decent mid.
Yeah.
I'll say that.
Definitely was.
It was a high mid.
I say high mid.
Mid-ish. It'll get off in the summer,
who
though.
Who told you bad man don't dance? Who told you gangsters don't dance? Yo. Even with a whip on my hip, I dance.
Hey.
Bad man, take another sip and dance.
Hey.
Two left feet, don't trip and dance. The girl want me, I might give her a chance. Give her a look, she give me a glance. She wore that tight dress just to enhance. You like a bomb.
It's actually kind of fire. Yeah.
He flies.
Yeah, he killed it.
Boom, boom, I got a long Johnson. And I will never met you at random. This must be destiny. That's why you're next to me. You feel like ecstasy. This must be destiny.
Yeah, he did.
I'm definitely not skipping it if it comes.
No.
Yeah, no, we're going to play this bitch out. We're going to play this bitch out.
Who told you bad man don't dance? Who told you gangsters don't dance? Even with a whip on my hip, I dance. Bad man, take another sip and dance. Two left feet, don't trip and dance. The girl want me, I might give her a chance.
We playing through the Drake or no?
She give me a glance. She wore a tight dress just to enhance. Touch my forehead, chest, left shoulder, then right side. Pray my brothers are good outside. I know the vibes, I know the vibes.
I know the vibes, I know the vibes.
Rolling eyes, I find love and it slowly dies.
He might have got Drake on this one, actually.
He did, yeah. But the thing
that last
that is starting to irritate me is how much he, Drake, makes his, he hops on anybody's song and he starts to do the, I'm a rap like you.
Oh, the game.
The game. He starts pulling the game a little bit. And
oh, okay.
I'm starting to get sick of it.
Just I got a piece for audio.
Because he could have snapped on this bitch regularly.
Literally.
Right here, this is Drake.
Yeah.
I mean, he still did.
Of course.
You know who would have killed this? Tory.
Tory would have killed. Tory would have slaughtered this joint.
Yeah.
Shout out to my guy, Daystar.
Yeah.
Hey. You one day stars.
One day stars.
Listen to that Roy Woods.
Yes. I like it.
Don't mind me.
I like it.
I thought we was going to City Girls. I need a thug, but I guess we're about where it was.
Okay.
I thought we were staying in the OVO.
What did he say?
I didn't know if we was going to act bad or not.
Nah, that's Diddy.
Don't mind me. Yeah, it's a new one.
Don't need to pretend.
Right, facts.
Can't let.
All you had to do was right by me.
mistakes we make every while. Fucked your friend, didn't know, baby, don't mind me.
Don't mind me.
Cause you ain't even a girl I claim as mine.
Come on.
I fucked your friend, didn't know, baby, don't mind me.
Come on. Come on.
Don't mind me.
He getting off. He getting off. He getting off. He getting off. He getting off.
Come on.
Don't mind me.
Don't mind me. I'm just over here in the corner. Come on, Roy. Where was this at? Where has it been at?
This is all we needed.
Roy. That ain't got a narrow party. It's about time. The party finally made some time for this nigga. That's a party. That's a party.
Yes.
Hello.
Yeah. This is definitely
party.
This is party. Who wrote this?
Yeah, go look. Go look. Hey, young dog. Hey, young dog, come here. Hey, kiddo. Come on. Come to this session tonight.
So, written by Denzel Spencer. I just know Noah Shabib is on here. That's about it. Yeah, this is definitely parties. Party wrote this shit.
Bro, even how it sounds right here.
Yeah.
That's crazy. This is a good song, though.
Yeah. Fire.
It's a good song.
I was happy to hear. I was like, okay, Roy is
finally
back.
Here.
He back.
Finally here, man. Did y'all hear that?
Why'd you just go to Reyes, bro?
070? I had a whole playlist lined up.
Okay, okay.
Y'all hear that 070 shake or no?
Uh-uh.
You hear this?
No.
Sound like 070 already.
You know 070 shake is dating chick from Idol?
What?
That's her girlfriend.
Who?
That's crazy.
Oh,
in real life.
Yeah.
Dating who?
Is dating old girl from Idol.
Like the main character.
Yes. Yes, on God.
Shout out to my nigga Shake.
Yeah. Crazy. Crazy. All right, man. We going to kick this off, niggas.
Yeah.
So this is what we got right here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tell your mama to bring me a plate. With her bum ass. Yeah.
Hey.
But she was fine in a mug back in the day.
Hey.
We got some Tiger YG and Blast on West Coast. Come on, man. Come on, yo.
Nice.
Man.
Hold on, who this?
This is Tiger YG and Blast. This is on West Coast. It's called West Coast Weekend.
Oh, yeah.
It just came out.
Yeah.
This better go off on Saturday.
Oh,
we gotta talk about the music from last time. I'm not. It was good.
No, do it.
But
do it.
I was ready to just pull up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'll tell you.
How do I say this right?
You don't have to. You don't have to. I literally told. We had a debrief the
okay.
next day. My exact words were, if y'all don't party for the bitches,
my point,
I'm gonna
that's
be upset.
All that I was about to say.
What are we doing here if the shorties ain't moving?
The girls, why did
they coming up to me like, yo, like I can't even vibe to this.
But I did see like one yuck mouth, like she was rapping everything from Detroit.
That's
dog.
Cute and all, but like. You got a party that's 50% girls and they all standing around because 100%. We playing this like.
But if he threw Blast on, it's a wrap. But he knew though, cause he did. He threw some Don Toliver on for a second. He had some on, and he's a great DJ.
But he kept getting requests. That's what it was.
Yeah, that shit was. That was some underground shit for sure. Not saying it was bad, Wayne. Don't beat me up.
Check.
Trust me, bro. I had to talk.
Yeah.
Cause it was literally homegirls after the party. Like, yo, I this was a vibe, but like, it wasn't a vibe for the shorties.
Yeah.
I'm like, bro, we gotta navigate that next time around. Like, it shouldn't be no shorties like not wanting to get like, you know, y'all just rapping to each other, weird ass niggas. What are we doing? Niggas just in circles rapping.
It would have been crazy if Glorilla went on. I think it would have been bananas.
It would have been crazy.
Just one. Like I think it would have been crazy. Yeah,
she would have had to know, turned up.
But he know he got it though.
Yeah,
if anybody could.
Yeah, pull. I will say too. The
somebody just
other one. She definitely played a lot of what the shorties would bop to. I don't think y'all was there when she started DJing though.
Nah, when I was there, dog food was going.
Yeah. But yeah.
Yeah.
She just played music for the shorties because she's a she. You know what I'm saying? So she already knew what was up.
The other one, what you mean by that?
Kins.
No. Was there? It was two that night?
Two DJs. But Dog Food came on later. We saying names, not fucking. Ken's came on. Yeah. Ken started earlier. You know what I'm saying? So the Ken's, right. Before Ken's got there.
Yeah.
Or when Ken's got there, wasn't really nobody there yet. Mm-hmm. She did the first half. Mm-hmm. But she definitely played the songs for the shorties. You know what mm-hmm. I'm saying? So it would have made more sense even if they went back and forth. Yeah, we talked about it, bro. Party's for the ladies.
Wasn't bad.
Ain't no point in party was nice.
Yeah, it was amazing.
Ain't no point in partying, you know, if the shorty's not shaking. I ain't got to shake booty, but they just vibing.
If you have that on all throughout the night.
Moving. They got to be moving. They got to be moving. So,
for sure.
Yeah. Gotta be moving. Come to Sunsets.
It's a packed weekend.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We still got one more Sunsets party.
Only July
8th. Last one. That's okay. My birthday party. Me and Austin. July 8th.
It's in Austin?
No, Austin's the guy who runs Camp Tao.
Oh, that's me birthday, in Austin.
His birthday is the 10th.
I thought you were saying you were going to Austin.
That's what I thought too.
Like Camp Tao was going to be in Austin? Yeah. That'd be crazy.
Just another thing that was on right. Victim.
Me and Austin birthdays is both early July. Mine the 1st, his the 10th. Tao's the 8th. So it's kind of like a joint birthday party / Camp Tao Sunsets event / get turned up with a / I'm not working / I'm going to be on my ass.
I love that for you.
Thanks, bro. I love that. I'm going to enjoy it.
I love that.
Turning 29 in a couple weeks.
We talked about it a little bit. Talked about the show, but the hit single from Idol.
Was it hit?
Idol.
Did The Weeknd write that?
The Weeknd knows how to write it.
Which one, Double Fantasy or Idol?
No,
the song that.
Oh, that shorty singing?
It's a hit?
In the show.
Oh.
It's supposed to be a hit.
Nah, I don't think that shit gonna flop. That shit gonna flop, I already know.
Yeah, I don't think The Weeknd write no more.
You don't think he write no more?
I think that he don't have, like Beyonce don't write no more.
It sounded like a Weeknd track. Or not like
it sounded his like track, but it sounded like he could have definitely played with the lyrics. It sounded like if he got lazy and wrote a song. Yeah. Which makes sense for the show. You just write some like mediocre.
Yeah, like kinda like here. Like,
yeah.
Use this.
Use that. Like it's just me rhyming words.
Yeah.
Easy. I can see that. Speaking of which, you guys always listening to. I've been listening to Drake's Trilogy a lot lately. Certified Lover Boy. Honestly, Never Mind. And Her Loss. Just like bouncing in between it.
Yeah.
I think when he said it was a trilogy, that definitely has been something that's like, I was like, damn, I can really see
how this aligns.
Yeah. I can actually, you can kind of hear the story of it a bit. And so I think CLB, obviously, like, I won't say it's full of love songs. I just think it's a very, it's a well-rounded album. Got a lot of different types of music on it, similar to like a Views, but I don't think it's as good as Views, respectfully.
Yeah.
But like, it's sort of there. I can honestly really see more of the, no pun intended, Honestly Never Mind into Her Loss, just because of the way the songs are kind of lined up. Yeah. Honestly Never Mind seemed like you're kind of over somebody a little bit, or getting over somebody, and you go into Her Loss and it's like, you're just kind of cutting up on this bitch.
Yeah.
So I can see where it flow. But anyway, I've been listening to all three of them, like, now that they're all out, and now that that's a trilogy, and the trilogy is over, and just kind of comparing it to, like,
yeah.
Comparing them to each other, and then comparing them to other, like, trilogies within, like, hip-hop.
Mm-hmm.
Or even, like, back-to-backs. Specifically Weekends. I don't know why I've been comparing it to that the most, but I think that's one. But
I love it.
That's where I've been at with music, for real, for real.
I see some Metro Boomin over there.
And Metro.
Yeah, the Spider-Man album still been on repeat. Been playing that at work a lot.
I thought it'd be different. I've been playing that Rory joint. That Rory album.
I stay and listen to that all the way.
I haven't gone back to it.
It's nice. It is nice. Yeah. Rory got some shit on there, man.
Yeah, I got to put that on my playlist.
It's actually, yeah. I think the first go ahead listen, I think we both kind of said, it's like, oh, this is chill. You can ride to it. The more I listen to it, there are like some songs that are actual gems on there that I'll are really nice. So yeah, check out. Shout out to my nigga Rory.
Yeah,
I still spend SZA at least once a week. I feel like
SZA get love. Yeah, it's a good album.
That album is top tier.
Y'all listen to Split Decision? Dave and Central C.
My Party Next Door.
Split Decision, the EP. This nigga stupid.
I did not know.
Okay, check it out. It's kind of straight.
Yeah.
Dave and Central C. So it's some overseas shit.
What's the artist song?
On there? It's only like a 5-pack, I think, right?
Something 4.
Like that. 4-pack?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Sprinter was my favorite.
For real?
Yeah.
What's going on? It's Tim Westwood TV.
The man them too inconsiderate. Five star hotel smoking cigarette, mixing Cody and up with a Finnegan. She got thick but she went to get Finnegan. Drinking hey. Apple cider vinegar, wearing skim cause she
got my piece.
Alright, I know they are bad, stop acting innocent. We ain't got generational wealth, it's only a year that I've had these millions.
My whip could have been in
a Tokyo drift car, it's fast and furious. I went from the Toyota Yaris to Urus, they had their chance but blew it. Now this guy want me and her uterus, fuck it, I'm rich, let's do it.
Take a look at these diamonds, wrong as a life for squinting. Can't
Dave got flow though.
With bae through thick and thin, she already fixed, so I'm halfway there.
Yeah.
Brown and bad, could have changed my mind, I was halfway there.
Yeah,
100 meters.
Yeah, I'm going in on that Slater. Yeah.
That shit nice. That nigga Dave said,
I gotta be.
He said, I need a bitch that's moving through thick and thin. She already thick, so I'm halfway there. I said, this nigga going stupid.
Big bars.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
That nigga dumb. That shit was lit.
That's what's up. What you been listening to? Spider-Verse, you said?
Listen to the Gunna track.
Yes, the, what's that? Extra butter or whatever that shit called?
Bread and butter.
Bread and butter.
Bread and butter.
Extra butter.
Chocolate butter.
The pot and four. What the fuck you talking about?
Which has no. Truffle butter, bread and butter.
Got an album coming out tomorrow.
Butternut bread.
I did see that. He do got an album.
He got an album dropping tomorrow.
Album dropping tomorrow from Gunna.
That's crazy.
I'm interested.
I'm interested too. We'll see.
I see that TikTok photo around. It's like, it's like, why y'all out here canceling Gunna? He's still in my playlist. Nigga ain't snitch on me. Y'all see that thing? Dog, I was crying.
It's true though.
Hey, nigga ain't snitch on me. This shit hard. Yeah, that shit was funny. I'ma listen though. I'ma see what he's talking about on there. I did like that that joint though. That wasn't a bad song.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll
see what it's hitting for tomorrow.
Yeah. That nigga skinny as hell now too.
Oh really? Been in a gym or
clone? Not eating.
Yeah.
Hey, clone Gucci. Hey.
Clone.
Then go to jail, come out.
Yeah.
It happens.
Change your life. You know, this year is focused on health, right?
Health as well, maybe.
You see what I mean? Yeah. Mm. It all happens. It happens that way. What else, man? What y'all been watching?
Idol. While we was on there.
Idol.
Idol's a big one.
Yeah.
That shit weird.
It's weird. I don't know how I feel about it, if I like it yet. But it is the only thing that's kind of like really on right now that's new. And it's, I mean, occupies my Sundays. Or I guess I don't really watch it when it come out. But my Mondays or Tuesdays. All American just dropped on Netflix a couple weeks ago. So okay. Wifey and I are catching up on the latest season of All American.
Yeah.
Okay.
Other than that.
I caught a couple episodes of All American just like in traffic, you know what I'm saying? Pulling up and it's on somewhere. I was like, this
shit. Yeah, your car got TV and a. You got.
Yep, it does.
That's crazy.
Yep, it does.
TV on the anyway, road.
Yeah.
You caught it
anyway,
in traffic.
Yeah, just caught it in traffic. But
that's
anyway,
crazy. So y'all be watching TV and camping.
Fucked up my whole shit. And so, like, I don't know, bro. I can't get with that show, though. It's too corny, man. It's a corny ass show to me. All American just corny. You be watching that shit and it just be like,
it is corny.
What the fuck is this?
Like, it is corny, but I'm here now in season 5.
So you gotta like finish that bitch out.
That's called commitment. The fact that old boy didn't play football like just threw me off when I was watching some YouTube videos. I was like, oh, he didn't even.
Yeah, the sports scenes are the worst for sure.
Oh yeah, yeah.
It's like a Disney Channel movie.
Oh, it's worse than that. I'd rather watch motherfucking High School Musical or some shit. Wait, them niggas playing sports and this shit. Shit booty.
Yeah.
Yeah. We just committed now, so.
You watch Ultimatum yet?
The Ultimatum. That's one of them dating joints?
Nope.
No. You watched that at the crib, though?
It was on.
Traffic.
No, I actually don't have no TVs in my car.
Oh, okay.
Actually, I can't watch Netflix.
Yeah, but say, nigga, you got an app. Yeah, look around.
I do, I got it.
You get the charger port.
Yeah, 100%. But nah, man, it a little different for sure. Ultimatum is interesting.
What other shows could you compare that joint to? Is it like any other dating show type shit?
It's toxic, bro. Like, imagine you and a significant other who wants to get married takes you to a show to say you either got to marry me or you can go date somebody else or you can break up with me.
Oh, I have seen it. I just ain't seen a new episode. It's a couple seasons.
Yeah.
Or I ain't seen the latest season or the last two
seasons. Oh, yeah, we seen it. We talked about it. Yeah. Zay and Ray?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's the queer season.
It's what?
I don't know if that's appropriate, bro.
You said it's the what season?
That's what it say on the.
Oh, like that's the title?
Yeah, that's
on Netflix?
Say. That's what it say on Netflix.
It says the what season?
Queer is a term that people use on the daily.
Okay. So, but you said it's the queer season? So the title is the Ultimatum Queer Season. I just wonder, like, is that what it's called? Just let me know so I know if we got to bleep these out or not.
Hold on.
Now you got to go check Netflix? Jay, you got to come.
And that's what Jay going to do. He's going to be like, yeah, it's a queer. You going to try to minimize it.
Yeah. Go ahead, Jay.
I'm telling you.
No, it says it right here.
Queer love.
Love. It's called Queer Love?
Queer Love.
The ultimatum, Queer Love.
Yes. Okay. Correct.
Close enough.
What, man? Why y'all looking at me? Why y'all looking at me, man?
I'm just saying what's on Netflix. There, like, it's on there.
All right, bet, bro. It's cool. Go out. Dog.
Dog? Yo.
Hey, Jamele. We just wanted to talk to you. Yeah. I came across our table. Just wondering. So what did you mean when you said?
Hey. What is wrong with y'all?
Five-letter word.
Not five-letter. That's nuts. That's nuts.
Yeah.
Just saying.
Shout out to...
Not the month.
Shout out to Tyler Perry.
Shout out to Tyler Perry for buying BET. Does he own VH1 now, too, as well?
BET and VH1.
Sheesh.
That's kind of crazy.
Yeah. First time that VH1 has been black-owned and BET back to being black-owned.
In like 20-something years.
Wow.
It's been actually kind of crazy.
Hey, shout out to Robert L. Johnson. Yes. RLJ Trust. He's the first founder of BET. He has a trust, which is one of the only, I think it's only 49 out of the top 500 stocks, black owned. Mm. That's just a precursor, because he did start with Sheryl Johnson. They started BET. Mm. And that's the last time it was owned by black people. Now goes over to Tyler Perry. I wonder if he's going to take that shit public.
I guess, would you?
No. If I'm Tyler Perry, all my shit has been private up until this point. All
right.
Control the product.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess it just depends on what he want to do, though, right? Like, if you want to go into, I mean, more bread, you would take it public, right?
Yeah, I would say. I would say, but private, you get to control.
Whatever
control
you do.
All your narrative and everything out there. And facts. Everything that Tyler Perry has done up until this point has been private, because and that's why what makes him successful. No discrepancy in terms of funds. He pays people well, it seems like. No one ever complains.
I mean, but then you also look at the fact that, like, do we want BET ran like a Tyler Perry network?
Who cares what you want? I got a profitable business.
True.
You know, I got writers here. I'm cranking it out.
Yeah.
And honestly speaking, nighttime, prime time, 7, 8, 9 p.m. is ran by my shows anyway. Seems like y'all niggas still like it.
Yeah, I guess it just depends.
Advocate. I'm here to banter for the capitalists.
I feel you.
This nigga said VH1 too, though. Let's get them niggas.
That's what I'm saying. What are we putting? We putting the motherfucking House of Pain on all that shit? Like, nonstop reruns? Like, what the fuck are we doing?
VH1 playing House of Pain or any of them Tyler Perry shows is crazy.
What was your favorite show on BET back in the day?
On BET? 106. Easy.
106.
Had to be.
Is that the consensus? Because I think I'd probably say 106.
106 for sure. That's the only shit I used to watch. That 106 and then like some movies sometimes. Like whatever movies came on. But that would be it usually.
Yeah.
I ain't watching that shit for shit else. Damn. This
thing. Yeah, I think 106 in the basement.
Yeah, the basement was the other one I was thinking.
Oh, the basement, nice. Yeah. We got a guest caller. Yo.
Guantanamo? I'm on.
Yeah, nigga, you calling this phone all crazy. I'm on the pause. Or what is
it? It's very. I needed you to, like, wingman with me, bro.
Oh, that's
okay, so I'm going to call you. I'm going to call you back when I get off the phone.
Shit, we got to wrap this shit
up.
Hey,
I'm going to call you when we get out of
here. We got to wrap this up.
Nigga, you're on the pod. Get off the podcast. I can hear you.
Hola. ¿Cómo estás?
Nigga, do you know we can see you?
Okay, go ahead. You talk crazy. Right. Go ahead.
So, I go to a wedding last week. This girl's really trying to fuck me, right?
Yep.
Now she's hitting me up right now.
Okay.
Saying, yo, I'm with your best friend, my boy who got married. We're at Manelli's. Pull up. And then my boy's like, bro, just pull up. She's like, she's DTF. She wants me in her guts.
Oh, shit.
So now, I'm like, well, shit. I'm like 3 days away from leaving.
Yeah.
What the hell?
Yeah.
And I'm like, all right, bet if I pull up, I'm going to see if Wayne want to pull up with me. But
why? I got to be here for this shit. Why? I can't just go home.
Alec. Ask him if he's in a good place at home.
You said what?
I said, ask him if he's in a good place at home.
Jay said, you know, this married ass nigga. Jay Tobar, are you in a good place at home?
Bro, but that's what I'm saying. Like, maybe, you know, I'm like, oh, I can't do it, but my boy Wayne, he can. And I'm like, yeah, she bad, bro.
Why you gotta put this on me?
Now you're in her guts?
No. I am in no one's guts. I don't want to be in anything. I just want to make money and live a successful life and pick up deer. That's what I want to do.
And pick up deer. She that's what I love that.
Okay.
I'll go.
I'm going to call you, nigga. I'm going to call you when we get out of here. All right. Wow. Friend of the show.
That was all in Spanish.
And it was.
We translated it to English.
Yeah.
So
It might have been rough.
Shout out to AI.
Yeah, facts.
And the AA. Man, big shout out to him.
Call me on that shit. That's the shit. Nigga's just. This is juicy for the
You should be thankful.
Hey, man. No, you know what man.
That text that she sent was crazy, though.
He was trying to give you the assist.
That was crazy.
Yeah.
That was really crazy.
I didn't even want to answer because it was something. Yeah.
I was actually occupied at the time. I was like, man, that's crazy.
You were. That's what you did Saturday night. Sorry.
Hey, yo.
Hey.
Hey, yo. Nah. Nah. Darryl killed everybody else. Everybody else will let some shit slide.
That was bad.
This nigga just threw it out.
That was bad.
You know what?
Because I just remember the text string.
Yes, I do too now.
Yeah. Yeah, so y'all didn't win Wednesday night, huh?
Wednesday night. Oh. You know what? What's winning?
Yeah, you know my answer, don't I don't bring it over here. Participation trophies. That's why I came to. I'm gonna be a tough ass dad.
This nigga was talking to Enzo about closing deals.
In a regular voice. In case you're grown, man.
So this is me right here.
So this is me talking to people about getting offers accepted. And he looked up at me and he said, damn, nigga, you really be doing that shit, huh?
Nah. Hey, man.
You know.
Tell you what, my mom says she never talked baby talk to me.
Yeah.
And I could talk pretty well at 10 months.
You definitely. And you got a little baby now, too.
So, Jay, what was you about to say?
I was going to go back to the last night, you know.
This episode, man.
It is.
I'm sorry,
it is,
man. Now, what do y'all bring me here for? This is, come
go
on.
Go ahead, Jay.
You mad at me now?
Nope. Go ahead.
You know, sometimes.
You mad at me.
Sometimes you don't got a win to win, you know.
Talk about it.
A win is a win.
Niggas see you and they respect you for what you do. You may not take the victory that day, but niggas know that you were winning.
I will say that is now we did walk in that bitch. And niggas was like, "Yeah, that's them boys over there." Y'all
okay,
I know that's them boys.
What's y'all theme song?
For me, anything Drake. Actually, there was a Drake song that came on, and I got the going stupid in that bitch. I forgot what song it was.
It was probably 4 p.m. in Calabasas.
It was
because that's usually the one.
I queued it up. I always queue it up, and now it's come on prime time.
Don't push me.
Cause close to
but one came on and we got our ass torched. That was the one when we took the L. Yeah,
rescue
we got torched,
us.
Bro.
Search and rescue, search and destroy, niggas.
We lost the game before the song came off. Yeah. That bitch was on and off before we got off the table.
That's not his best work though.
Yeah, it's a good song. I'll do it.
Like it's a good song. Yeah, don't get me wrong.
It's this that beat switchover.
Don't put me up in W.
Yeah, I did, baby.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Send the PLC and come and see me, baby. That shit hard.
Yeah.
That shit hard. Listen, I.
Yeah, I think this happened.
Yeah.
We actually had some decent music last night, though. I mean.
You ain't get no.
There were pockets where, like, there was some music playing, but.
That's right.
No Morgan and Dirk.
Morgan and Dirk was not in the queue.
Nah.
I don't know why, but, you know.
And 2 a.m. at a Broadway bar. But, yeah, man.
Nah, not that one, but the new one is.
It kind of slap, huh?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
I rock with it.
With that being said, what are we about to do? We about to wrap up the pot?
We can go into the wind down real quick.
Let's wind down.
Yeah, real quick.
Let's get out of here.
All right, 30 seconds or less.
Oh, I was going to stop it.
Oh.
Yeah, stop that.
All right. Yeah, he did.
Oh,
he's going
out.
What? Oh, no.
Birthday.
Not when you say it.
Oh, it's not. Not for his
no,
birthday?
But when you
he's
say
not going to celebrate the birthday? Not the
when
guy?
You said that means it's happening. That's why I don't like that shit. We really going out? We doing this?
Hey, we got to go get Alec.
Bro.
I got to fix this headphone. Wait.
I need a shower, my niggas. Yo.
Sorry.
It's right there.
Hey, I'm full-fledged tonight, boys.
Yeah, cool.
I got my workout in the middle of the day, niggas. So,
I did too. Yeah, I just ate shower after, man.
Yeah, that's what you. That's a hack. That's a peaceful moment in the middle of your day. It's the shower.
I'm telling you, bro.
It's a hack.
It's like the day restarts, mm-hmm. bro. Literally, the day restarts. Yeah. I love that shit.
Going to work. I don't know what the fuck it is. My body be like different between 9 a.m. and 12. Like, you know how they talk about passive sweat and shit like that. Like, I don't know. But when I hit that 1 p.m., 2 p.m. shower,
boy, it's so on.
I've been doing cold showers too.
Midday cold showers?
Reset your whole day. I know you had to do it for you as in the service and shit like that. But yeah.
I mean, I don't do that shit for fun no more, nigga. Like, the fuck? I did that shit since then.
Okay. Shit ain't fun.
Nigga. As soon as we got out of basic training, nigga, my water was back warm. That's what you're talking about. Like, my shit hot, actually. Scorching.
Showering. Y'all niggas was crazy, huh? Y'all thought y'all was going to kill us. Look at me now, nigga.
Little bitch. Just put my shit back hot.
Did my time.
Hey, fuck out of here.
Bro, they got to be a support group, though, for real, in the service, dog. I couldn't imagine what she was going through. Like, and I thank you for what you was going through, but like,
I'm gonna keep it a buck, bro. I wasn't going through shit, bro.
No, I'm talking about not from the training, but just from like
I didn't go through shit, bro.
The people that you was around.
The only thing I had to deal with some little racist fucks from time to time.
And this is stuff, everything bro. I'm talking about
we
right now.
You do this
now.
Every it's day. Like, you deal with the same shit, bro.
I know, bro, but like
you do the same shit.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. But I also you was a part of Air Force too, which is the preferred.
Yeah, everybody prefer the Air Force if you're going to do one.
100%. But you got to be smart.
I know
there.
Dumb nigga.
You got to be smart to get
dumbass Marine niggas. No, I'm playing. Let me stop. I love all y'all. Y'all still stupid.
Give me a gun.
Yeah, still stupid. Y'all still stupid. But yeah, I love y'all. Yeah, bro. I say it's like any other job, nigga. It's just a job. It's a job in America.
Yeah.
It's like being corporate.
Shout out to Jokic for saying that today. This week.
Hey. Yeah. I fucked with it. I did, though, see a couple posts that made a lot of sense to me. It was like, yo. When Jokic said y'all love it, but when Kyrie said it's a problem, I was like, Kyrie did say a lot that it's not that far off.
I'm not far off at all.
It's not that far off.
It's
man.
Not. It's not. It's it, that is so true. But like, damn, my nigga just won a championship. Like, I'm going to Russia.
I'm not Serbia. Fucking with you, niggas.
That nigga need to get out of the country for sure.
Yeah. You see what they was like? He was like, they was like, you excited for the parade? He was like,
it's like Thursday?
He said, when's the parade? They was like, Thursday. He was like,
I'm supposed to be in.
I got to go home. Yeah. They was like, you go home on Friday. He was like, okay. Dog, I was like, this nigga really ready to go, bro. He's so over all of this.
Yeah.
I did see the video today. He did say the parade was a vibe and he was fucking with it.
He's like, I want to stay.
Yeah. But
you know, my boy Andrew Tate got a place in Romania too.
Boy Tate,
y'all want to talk about Tate? What's y'all views on? Let's start podding. What's y'all views on Andrew Tate?
To be honest with y'all, I'm gonna let y'all cook here because I don't have a opinion on Mr. Tate. I mean,
you said like you haven't listened to enough of them, or like,
so what? Like, exactly. Would you consider yourself sliding a second or third right here,
or home?
Cause you safe.
Yeah, I'm on base. I might actually, you know, like I got to base, and I'm gonna let y'all run for me. So, you know, cause my leg is bad and my knee is bad, so I'm gonna let y'all.
Yeah, you slid in on that shit.
I say. I ain't got no beef with Andrew, man. I say this, bro. Do niggas say radical shit sometimes? Yes. But I think that's on both sides. Women say crazy shit. Men say crazy shit. Alpha men say crazy shit. Beta men say. Everybody say crazy shit. Do I think that everything he says is completely false? I don't. And I'm not like the one to harshly criticize it. I think in real life, what you do when you listen to anybody is take pieces of it. You don't take the whole fucking thing. That's a sheep. I'm never going to be a sheep to niggas. But when that nigga say, like, he'll say some shit like, yo, a girl wearing little clothes to the bar or little clothes to the club is to attract male attention. I can't disagree with that. I do think every time you do that, I don't care if you do it and you don't, you might not, it might not mean you saying you want a nigga to come be all in your face or do something crazy to you. But you're doing it to look good. And typically, if you're doing it to look good, you're doing it so niggas look at you. That's just what niggas do the same shit. Men do the same fucking thing. I'm not getting fly for you niggas. I'm getting fly so the shorty say I'm fly. It's life. That's real shit. So yeah. I'm not mad at the nigga. Do he say some crazy shit sometimes? Yeah, but I'm not going to say he just completely false in all his ideals. What about you?
Same. I think that more times are right. I agree. I think that the thoughts on men being very strong and understanding that. He said one thing where men, you control everything in your life. And if you do not like where you are in your life, it is 100% your fault. And I think extreme accountability needs to be taken upon. I don't like, and especially in our environments, I think there is precursors in terms of the cards we were dealt.
Yeah.
But if you are a male that's over 25, 100%, you have to take accountability and say, like, no, if my life is shit, my life is shit. Because of where I deserve to be here. And I put myself here. It is what it is. And it's those people that get realistic about their lives and they say, oh, shit. It is my fault. I can change this. And they get up and say, I have potential to change this and make my life better. That's it. People that said that shit, it's like, can't fucking help you. And then you cut them out. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It is what it is.
True. 100%.
Yeah.
Talk that shit, man.
That was a remix, but yeah.
Talk that shit.
I do feel that way.
Yeah.
How do you help? How do you pull people up? But anyway, with that being said, speaking of pulling people up, motherfucking Nuggets pulled it out. You know what I mean? They pulled
Shout
up.
Shout out to them boys. Congratulations to the Denver Nuggets for their first ever title win.
100%. What a moment when seeing Jamal Murray hug the owner and say, hey, thank you for not giving up on me.
That's some real shit.
Yeah.
That is real.
That's some real shit.
I know I was damaged goods, but thank you so much. Thought that was real.
Shout out to them. I mean, they played their ass off. They're the best team in the league. I mean,
I agree.
I think it showed, like, best team in the league won the shit. So kudos to them.
That shit boring, but you know.
Whose performance was better, Andrew Wiggins or Aaron Gordon's?
You said who?
Whose performance was better?
I would say Wiggins or Gordon. Wiggins last year. Because I think Wiggins was a player that was this highly, like, sought-after player when he was drafted.
Yeah.
It was like, yo, Wiggins going to be that dude. And he wasn't that dude for quite some time. And then to see him, like, show off in the finals last year, I was like, okay, like, this is the Wiggins that we all thought mm-hmm. we were getting years ago. Nothing against Gordon, because, I mean,
he balled.
Yeah, he balled for sure. But I think Wiggins was a dude that, like, had all the hype behind him. And to see him, like, yes, you know, like, he's on a team with Curry, Clay, all these guys. But for him to, like, show out in the finals against the Celtics was, I think, was like, okay, you are him. Like you are him. So.
Yeah.
So for me, it's Wiggins for sure.
Heat.
I can see that.
But yeah.
I can see that. I guess I can kind of go same thought process. I think bigger than anything, I think that performance he had, he damn near had to carry them niggas a little bit. Like he had to actually put like some of that shit on his back.
Wake?
Yeah.
Yeah, he did.
And so I think that's where I'm kind of like, all right, I got to give it to that nigga.
Yeah. Because
like you said, a lot of niggas, he was washed to a lot of people at that point. So I had to give it to him. But like you said, bro, these Nugget boys, man.
Scary.
Hey. they could do it again.
Yeah, I think so.
They could do it again.
I think they got the mark on league for a little bit, man. What else y'all been up to this week outside of the finals, man, though?
Shit, bro.
I was telling Wayne, I was telling you a little bit too, potentially, but starting to get back to, like, again,
working on our health.
Working at health, so got a couple miles in last week.
Mm-hmm.
Ran around there's a trail like right around the house or by the house.
Back on the 10K. So,
but was spinning a block twice, huh?
You know, I'm getting, like it ain't nowhere to park.
You know, I'm getting a couple miles in. You know, I'm trying to like get back to that. You know, to that healthy state as far as physical goes. But I was also telling Wayne like we got to get that evening hoop run going. Like, we gotta find one. Like,
ironically, I think they was talking about doing one tomorrow. Now, I'll be out. But, you know, for niggas that wanna go hoop, kill beans. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm out of town.
I'm out of town. Why you gonna say, why your octave change? What you
mean, like?
Just when you have to W-I-D mean, baby.
Not Friday nights, but you
weekday,
know.
Weekday.
You know what I'm saying?
Like catch early you. Weekday. Yeah. Evening run.
I would love a Monday night run.
Monday through Thursday. I even feel like Sunday through Thursday is really
Sunday
a
too.
Run.
A Sunday night run ain't bad.
Sunday would be nice.
I would take a Sunday and shit. I mean, even Tuesdays, even though them pod nights, you know what I'm saying? You guys just let us know the time. We can we can come through. We came through drunk before.
And went undefeated.
And put a bucket. Yeah.
Undefeated and you argued.
Yeah. Yeah. That was fun.
I saw For that gentleman that dissed this last time, I saw an Instagram post that made me reassess things. And I'm not going to look at either of you because I'm not going to stop what I'm saying. I don't want to. Can I go off?
Yeah.
Okay.
Cook, boy.
If you rent your lifestyle on a trip, I do not want you around me or in my circle. There's no reason to be around you. If you rent the cars that you drive and that's all that you post, if you don't post any promotional content around like how you get into where you get into, I think it's all fake and fraud. And you can rent these cars for $150 a day. I do not give a fuck about what you're driving. I do not give a fuck about what type of shoes you have on. I do not give a fuck about what type of bracelet you have on unless you can show me the work that you put in. And then when I see you in real life and you're dusty as fuck, I don't want to hear it at all.
IRL.
Now I can look at you guys and say.
No, don't look at me, bro. Don't look at me.
Now I can look at you guys and say, that's how I truly feel because I have seen that. And it was one of those moments where I was like, that's fucking fraud. That is 100% fucking fraud. And I feel bad about those individuals that you're coming into contact with, whether it be male or female, and you're saying this is what your life is really like. But who am I to judge? Because God, But who am I to judge?
You rip a nigga to shreds and say, who am I to judge is crazy. you indeed just judged, nigga.
Only because he dissed my guys. only because he dissed y'all. The way he came at it, because you're a fucking sore loser and you don't know how to be a man. Yeah, yeah, and it all reverts back because this shit is fake. Like, you're a sore loser. If you were actually working in the fucking gym on your shit, you probably would have been able to play some fucking defense. Like, am I real? None of this.
You cooking with grease, big dog.
My bad, bro.
With grease.
My bad.
With grease. Like,
Crody.
Turn me.
Bro, you good.
Did y'all see that or no?
Heat check. Which one?
No, you straight, we seen it.
Yeah. Okay.
I just didn't respond.
Yeah.
It's nothing to respond to.
Like you said, I'm responding to half the shit in there.
Yeah, I ain't gonna hold you. But hey man, I feel you.
Yeah.
I think end of the day, I let niggas make poor choices.
Yeah.
You make poor choices, play stupid games, you're gonna win stupid prizes.
Mm-hmm.
Simple as that.
That's all. Because whoever you are attracting with that look and that facade, they're going to want you for that look and that facade, and you can only keep that going for so long.
100%, bro.
So it's cool.
Hear me out, bro. How fucked up is it to, like, no, I'm going to be real. Like, how fucked up is it to not live your real life and to rent a life on your fucking trip and vacation with a whip?
Because you got to go back home to.
And then you go back home and your shit ain't even. Like, what nowhere the near fuck? That. Like, you setting yourself up. You setting your whole generation. Like, that just puts you back further.
Yeah.
You go to another city to flex. Like, nigga, you could really get the fuck off here if you really. Like, respectfully. Like, you could really get the fuck off here. For 100%. Real, for real. Mm-hmm. You don't even got to get all of that. Like, I just thought about it. I'm looking at it. Like, what a disgrace. You niggas. You niggas. You niggas. You. I've always wanted to say that. You niggas. Man, let's start with this pod, bro, before I go off. Come on, man.
All right, man. Look, let me start here so we just get the fuck on.
Yeah.
I got that champagne, the real champagne from Champagne, France. Mm. The Inspiration 1818 Brut, non-vintage. This shit just got bottled. Alcohol, 12%. Yesterday, shipped over. No aging. 12% on this one. I dig it, man. It's champagne. It's light. It's crisp. I definitely enjoy it. I think it's interesting because I don't think I've had a true champagne in a while. It's typically sparkling wines a lot of the time. And so can kind of taste the difference or feel the difference a little bit. I feel like just general speaking, I feel like this champagne feels a lot lighter on me. It doesn't hit me as hard. Like, I don't even feel like I've really been drinking a lot.
And I haven't, like, had it, but is it, like, completely dry? Like, do you feel like it's a little, like on the sweeter side?
It's pretty dry. Don't get me wrong. It's pretty dry. I don't really get too much of a sweet palate or nose from this. Pretty dry, pretty clean, really crisp. It just feels really light, which I enjoy. I think this is something. I can see why you party off champagne if this is what you're drinking in comparison to, like, a sparkling wine. I think feels a bit different for me.
Big shout out to the Roots Fund.
Always.
Then that was crazy. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Went to champagne.
Yeah, that was That was a hard car ride to the airport for sure.
We ain't talked that whole day.
The whole day. I'm traveling with these niggas. I think the most I did was get lunch for my mans, bro. That was the most we talked, I think, in that spot. I'm like, bro, thank you for flying us out here, bro.
I couldn't even think, like, dog. I was done.
Thank you for flying us out lunch. After that, there was nothing else, bro. Like, that, nothing else.
Yeah, that felt bad for Ace Wayne. Ace of Spades was nasty.
That Ace of Spades was crazy. I still got that picture though, Nick. I Ace of Spades and French fries in my head. That shit was iconic. That's an album cover. I was thinking about grabbing something for my birthday too though. But that shit a little grip over at Total Wine, boy. I'll tell you what. I think I'll just get a Moet model or two. I could do the Moet. We're not gonna fake this lifestyle.
Okay, here we go. But the funny thing is, where are you at? Where are you doing that?
You're right, man. At your home. At my old party. At my old shit. Yeah, you're right. That's facts, man.
There ain't nothing wrong with the Moet and
shit. No, I would take the Moet. I would take the Moet for sure. It was just I inquired on Ace real quick. It was just an inquiry. Yeah. I'm done. Go ahead, Jay. Oh shit!
It's funny because I looked at the Ace for the 100th episode, and I was like,
"That Ace boy."
Did we have Ace on the podcast?
Chicken knows what he's doing.
No, what we have? Ace. We had Dom. Yeah,
I think we had Dom for like your birthday.
Yeah, it was a couple years ago. But I looked at the Ace too. I was like,
Ace. That's a pair of shoes, player. That's like some real shit. Like, I could keep something for that.
Half my motherfucking mortgage.
Quit fucking playing with me. I'm going to hold that.
Don't play with me.
Man. I see one that had like a price for like, I think it was like $250. And I was like, oh. It was like, no, $250 if you buy more than 12 bottles. I said, oh.
Wow.
So I need a case to get this deal. Cute. Like, I'm not buying that. Yo, what's up, man?
Shout out to the Veritas, the Centella, the Monticello, ADBA. This was a vibe. This one does have a little bit of dosage or some sugar there. So I think it's about... maybe, I don't know the actual residual sugar, but there is some sugar here. I think it's 100% Chardonnay, if I remember correctly. But it's a vibe. You get some, like, bready tones, some brioche tones, some nice, like, citrus fruits, maybe, like, hints of, like, some apple or, like, tree fruits kind of shining. But moderate bubbles, got some nice acidity. It's a good sip. Like I said, the sugar doesn't really turn you off all the way. And, again, it's done in that method where you still get, like, those traditional champagne notes. So I'm gonna probably go 8.5 for this guy. And I'm gonna just say here right now, if it's like 8.3 or higher, I'm gonna get another bottle. When it gets under that 8 is where I'm like, all right, I'm like toying with right. Like maybe
back
I'll
and forth type shit.
Maybe I'll revisit. But once it hits that number, like, I rock with you. So I would definitely get another bottle of this.
I love it. The Born Rosé, 8.7. Had a great time with this one. Almost finished a bottle. Could finish a bottle. I was about to drink from the top, but we going out tonight, so it is what it is.
Yeah, we.
This is Music in a Bottle Podcast, episode 139.
Live your real life, nigga.
Come in.
Live your real life.
Don't come to me. Just because you're losing a pickup game. You know what I mean? Don't come at me like. Yeah, bro. Yeah. 12 points. You had a plus minus score of negative 12.
Y'all thought this shit was sweet out here, boy.
Go get a haircut.
We don't buy much. We buy land, bro.
Talk to these niggas, Jay. Talk to these niggas, Jay.
That's all we doing, man.
Yeah, nigga.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't want to go into that talk.
You cop rentals, but do you got renters? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It's just...
come on.
It's a disgrace.
Come on.
And I just don't know how you look your ancestors in the eye.
You know what I mean? How you dream at night?
Yeah.
Especially with Juneteenth right around the corner.
You spent that on Toro.
We gotta go.
You spent that on Toro.
We gotta go.
You know what I mean? You know what I mean? It's just $3,500 for a down payment. You spent that on Toro.
We gotta go. Hey, man, we focus on. We love y'all, man. Episode 139,
in
man.
In New Mexico.
We gotta get out of here.
You know what I mean? At a 3-star.
I must put a ticket.
That nigga said he was indeed at the Double Tree. He had the joint pop that tracked at the Double Tree.
On Frontier.
Nigga drinking, eating continental breakfast.
That's it. Include the first class flight. Include the Delta Skyline. Include just show me and if you're gonna. If you're gonna go all the way, then just go all the way for real. Because if that's what we're doing now,
hey, that's what we doing.
If that's what we doing now, is that what we're doing now? That's what we doing now. Okay, bet. Yeah, sounds good.
Hey, love y'all, man. Yeah, 139. We out, bro.